My name is Alla Mikheyenka, and today the title of my poster is Sequencing of Individual Barcoded cDNAs Reveals Platform-Specific Error Patterns. I will start with describing the main features of our data. We had cDNAs that were barcoded by their single cell of origin or their spatial location. Each cell had a unique 16 base pairs barcode, and each molecule had 12 base pairs UMI, unique molecular identifier. Then, PCR copies of the same cDNA molecules were sequenced on both the PacBio Sequel II and Oxford Nanopore Promethion. This approach allows us to practically compare the same individual RNA molecules sequenced on different platforms. Thus, we analyzed pairs of reads where ONT and PacBio read represented the same individual RNA molecule. Each read pair was identified by the combination of its barcode, a UMI, and the gene the molecule is mapped to. Then, we compared sequencing errors and intron structure in identified read pairs. PacBio expectedly showed much higher qualities than ONT reads. Most PacBio alignments to the reference were slightly longer, although the difference was small, up to 14 base pairs. ONT has significantly more errors than PacBio, but a large fraction of PacBio errors occur on homopolymers, while ONT errors frequently arise from other areas. These were mostly known differences between PacBio and ONT. However, our main goal was to investigate how platform-specific features affect downstream analysis. We considered an intron chain of every read and performed three-way comparison of intron chains between read pairs and the annotation using IsoQuant tool. In most read pairs, the PacBio and the ONT read had identical intron chains. In 16% of cases, intron chains between the reads in the pair disagreed. For most of these disagreeing pairs, we see that PacBio read often precisely agrees with the annotation, while ONT read does not. This suggests that PacBio alignments unsurprisingly give more precise splicing structure. Here is an example of disagreeing reads. The first exon is shorter in ONT read and doesn't match the annotation. This analysis was done by exact comparison of splice site coordinates. However, we know that in nanopore alignments, splice junctions may be detected with some minor shifts, so we decided to perform inexact comparison, where splice junctions are considered equal if the distance between them doesn't exceed some delta. Here is 6 base pairs. Here is an example of a read pair where splice junctions differ by 6 nucleotides, and during an exact comparison, we say that these reads agree in terms of intron chains. In exact intron chain comparison with delta reduced disagreements between paired PacBio and ONT reads nearly in half. Among the remaining disagreements, the trend of PacBio being more consistent with the annotation is preserved. Overall, 74% of ONT and 36% of PacBio mappings inconsistent with the annotation during exact comparison were reclassified as annotated with delta equals 6 base pairs. Reads can be inconsistent with the annotation in different ways. Here we show statistics on the most common disagreements. As we can see, ONT reads, shown with blue, have much more inconsistencies than PacBio reads. In addition, we have a bunch of events supported by both platforms, shown as brown, suggesting that these inconsistencies may be real. Here we show an example of exon skipping event. If an exon is relatively short, the aligner software can erroneously map a read and skip this exon. PacBio and nanopores skip exons shorter than 15 bases with similar frequency. However, ONT exon skipping affects also exons up to 40 base pairs length. On this slide, we have a histogram of distances between alternative and annotated acceptor sites. Interesting that most upstream 3 base pairs shifts, so-called NAG-NAG acceptors, were supported by both PacBio and ONT. At the same time, downstream ONT acceptor shifts are not supported by PacBio reads. For inconsistent donors, a downstream shift of 4 base pairs mostly occurs for ONT data. Such shifts are caused by misalignment at the commonly known GT and NGT donor motif. The observations described above are based on read pairs, which require a detected barcode and remind both the PacBio and the ONT read. However, ONT reads with barcodes have higher read quality than those without. We wanted to know whether our observation on the small subset of higher quality reads can be extended to the full dataset, so we analyzed the entire ONT dataset. We observed that higher quality reads were significantly longer and had one more detected intron on average. Then we compared each read intron chain against undated transcripts. The inconsistency rate goes down with higher read quality score. Moreover, inconsistency increases with longer intron chains. We also examined problematic splice junctions where several canonical nucleotide pairs are located nearby, and thus the aligner can make a mistake. It is known that some sequences represent a challenging task for aligners, like GTGT, NAG-NAG, and GTN-NGT motifs. We first counted all problematic annotated splice sites in the genome. The most common case is GTN-NGT motif that is typical for eukaryotic donors. We also see that almost no annotated acceptors have a canonical pair upstream. We then counted how many times each problematic splice site was incorrectly called by ONT alignments. We suggested that the probability of the site being called incorrectly depends on how close the nearest canonical pair is rather than some particular motif. Thus, we computed the relative inconsistency rate, percentage of incorrect calls rather than the absolute number. We found a strong dependency for donor sites. Inconsistency decreases when canonical pair is farther away and when read quality is higher. For example, the probability of a downstream 4 base pair shift caused by GTN and GT motif is 2 times lower than of a downstream 2 base pair shift near GTGT, despite GTN and GT being vastly more frequent overall. Here is a short conclusion based on our comparison of the same RNA molecules sequenced by different platforms. ONT alignments may skip short exons up to 40 base pairs and have inexact splice site positions. Most frequently, splice site shifts occur near common GTN-NGT motif. However, this can be partially solved by using inexact splice site matching or some sort of error correction. At the same time, alternative acceptor sites near NAG-NAG motifs may be real. Due to higher error rate, nanopore alignments may not provide exact splice site coordinates, especially for the cases when read has low quality, read has multiple introns, and canonical denucleotides are located nearby splice sites. So the alignments meeting listed criteria should be treated with an additional care. I would like to thank all my colleagues from St. Petersburg State University and from Weill Cornell Medicine, and I thank you all for your attention.